I think for the first time I saw the Vikings win the cold field advantage. Did you feel that yesterday?
Yeah, absolutely. I think, you know, the fans were there, and, you know, third downs and stuff, we really felt them, how loud they were. But the biggest thing was, as a team, we felt like we had the advantage playing in the cold. You know, we've obviously been up here, it's been a cold November, so we were kind of used to being around and being in it and practicing outside, you know, practicing indoors with the doors open in the cold weather, and I think we had the advantage.
I'm sure some of the old-timers have talked to you about that, the advantage of playing outside.
Yeah, you know, we've heard the, we've seen the Vikings, old Vikings film with Bud Grant and how they used that cold to their advantage and made it a true home field advantage. And for us, it was, we're trying to get to that point, you know, and obviously playing outdoors, we have two more outdoors, we want to make that our advantage.
There's no question this team is not mailing it in. That says something about Zim, it says something about the leaders on this team.
Yeah, I mean, we're looking at 9-7. I mean, we want to be 9-7, and you know, with how maybe things fall your way, maybe you get a couple breaks and get an opportunity to make the playoffs. You have no idea how it's going to shape up or how the season's going to finish. So for us, it's about winning every ball game, and not only for our fans, for ourselves, for the coaches, but the realistic chance that we have a chance to still get in the playoffs.
You'll win all four of those games if you hold your opponent to 13 points every game. That was a good effort.
Yeah, you'll have a good chance to do that, and you know, we have some tough offenses coming, you know, down the road. But if we can do that defensively and play good in the red zone, really, you know, to hold those first two drives that were scoring drives to 6 points rather than 14 or even 10, you know, that's just a huge advantage for us.
You were on the field for one of the blocked punts for a touchdown.
Yeah.
From your vantage point, what happened?
Yeah, it's sort of one of those things we work on all the time, but you never get to the point where you can truly get a rush, and Jasper hit a great up and under. I was rushing my guy, had made it past him, but Jasper beat me there, and I don't think I'd have got to the punt block like Jasper did. Ball bounced off my hip and looked back, and is right in Everson's hand. It's just sort of a great hop. And to have two punt blocks is obviously impressive, but to have those both go for scores are unheard of.
So you're saying that you could have been the guy scoring a touchdown had you been a little quicker.
I wish. I couldn't find the ball. I felt it hit me, and that was it. But I wish I would have been the guy in the end zone, but happy somebody got there.
Everson's been pretty amazing this year. I mean, obviously this play, he is a big play player.
Yeah, I mean, he's so explosive. I mean, he's to watch him mature as his career has gone on has been awesome. To see him develop into an every down player has been fun to watch. I mean, people see the stats on the sacks and stuff, but you know, his play against the run is as good as anybody's, and you know, we rely on him to be a big playmaker for us. So he's definitely the MVP of our defense. Him and Harrison have just played great football for us. So those two guys have been standouts.
Another guy who has grown is Xavier Rhodes, and you've noticed that too.
Yeah, you know, the thing with Xavier is the interception numbers aren't there, but his ability to pass the defense, to be able to put him on the opponent's best receiver at times and let him work is a huge advantage for us.
Teddy making another step, and that has to be nice. You see it in practice, so it doesn't surprise you, I suppose, to see it on the field.
No, I think that drive before halftime was huge, just to see how he commands things in a tough situation, cold weather. Sort of one of these things where him wearing gloves is a huge advantage for our team because he's used to playing with gloves on in cold weather. You know, obviously you're more comfortable having gloves on. So to see him grow week to week and struggle through some tough losses, some tough games, and come back and play well and be efficient is nice.
You were still sleeveless out there yesterday.
Yeah, always sleeveless. I don't care how cold it gets. But I think they said the seventh coldest game in Vikings history. When you factor in all those Met games back in the old Met, it was a cold one. So, you know, who knows what's going to happen this weekend or at the end of the year when we play Chicago. But got to play sleeveless football.
This is not a very good example for your kids.
No, my kids got to have the coats on.
I mean, someday sure. Your kids will say, but Dad.
Yeah, exactly. I'm sure it'll come back and bite me in the butt. But, you know, when you're out there playing football and there's only one way to play it, and that's just, I just can't fathom wearing sleeves. It's weird.
How happy is a team and a veteran like you to see Adam Thielen have success?
Incredible. I mean, to see, you know, where Adam, how he made it onto our squad, the way he's fought for his position, every scrap he can get, and then just to push into a nice role as a receiver. The things he does there are, you know, he's gonna catch the ball when it's thrown to him. He's gonna block when he's told to block. He's gonna do things the right way. You know, be a Minnesota native to have a big game like that is just a pretty cool experience for him and great for us as teammates because he's a great teammate.
Every team needs an Adam Thielen or two.
Yeah, I mean, I think every team, but not only that, but it's just great for organization, great for the state, you know, great for Minnesota State. I mean, that with their program still doing well, I mean, it's fun to have him on the team.
Up next, the J-E-T-S, Jets, Jets, Jets.
Yes, Jets, Jets at home. You know, it's going to be another one, a home field advantage for us again, hopefully in the cold weather, and hopefully make it work.
Is it a little bit easier to come to work now, you know, knowing that hey, we won this game, going to be the favorite the next week, we can get on a roll here.
Yeah, to put two in a row is just a huge feeling. You know, it's a great feeling to win, great feeling in the locker room, coming to work this week, and everybody, the vibe is just better. And now it's about stringing two together and just get rolling. You know, you got to be good in December football and as an organization and try to kind of lay that groundwork for that. So hopefully we can continue to do well.